Yeah, I'd hit the button. Sorry, nobody else is making videos, so I guess I will. That's pretty much how it always worked. Always will. Always. Like that word makes any sense. Anyway, so this progression, I was just thinking about this idea of reflexes and the idea of logic. Which means kind of like, you know, over time, the logic and the reflexes would grind, and over time, there would be an efficiency to the words and their connections and their definitions, and the phrases would get more and more established and more written in cement in terms of, yes, this is the reality of life. And all the slowly but surely through this process of what we're going through, we're sort of the means to the end. We're part of the grinding that will grind to a halt eventually. When all that's needed to be known is known by the substance of the knowers, kind of a thing. And so as it currently stands, people in the last 100 years have had a lot of revelations. They're starting to get a clue. They're dropping. Well, see, you say they, and you really have to distinguish between that part of the human race that's in civilization and that part that's outside of civilization, because they really are functioning quite differently. But let's say the educated part of the human race can start to see the grinding. She just don't look right. The young one. Yeah, she's got a bad leg. Stumbling along. Back leg. Probably better than the front anyway. The intelligent people can do this logic thing, this word game play, and start refining definitions and understandings of what this thing is doing. And the fact is that's all it's doing, is trying to find these straighter lines between the thing needed and the needer. And I would say logically, like I said, eventually the obvious, the most logical conclusion will win, and they will realize the simplest is the straight line, and the even simpler is just smash the two points together and don't bother chasing anymore. Don't contrive the distance, and you won't have to travel the distance, kind of a thing. And that's sort of where the logic and the all the words will point eventually, is to this conclusion that we're just processing a problem, that doesn't need to exist. We're thinking and doing all of this work, and it is kind of work to think, to figure out the truth and what to do about it. We're going to figure out that the answer was not to bother. That you can't really make it out of what we have as materials. That the ingredients will not make food. they won't make anything that can be rationally sustained, is a playable game. Because the game was always a contrivance. It was contrived by a DNA molecule. It was always fake. There was nothing real ever sought, and that's why we're just playing a survivor's game, not a winner's game, not a do something productive game, just a game of I will make you need survival, and I'll make you chase it, and it's just a contrivance. And that will occur, that the word contrivance and the word survival will end up being words associated with each other. The reflex between those two words will become much more straight line. And when somebody says reflex or somebody says logic, what will occur to them is the pure logic of solving a problem by not creating a problem. These simple statements, first do no harm, will become more and more associated through reflexive logic with the fundamental truth that lies in them. That is their, that's where they belong. That's where they belong on the association board, the proper association between these words. Futility is thy name. Humanity will become reflexively associated with, obstinance and, futile persistence and waste. And that it took it so long to figure out it's playing a game that is so wrong. So anyway, I shall finish on the way back and such. And whatnot. Yeah, so till then. I'm back. Anyway, so where were we? I shouldn't do that. I should already know where I am. Should have already thought about it, but I did. So logic and its progression and its evolution. Evolution of knowledge and acquisition of understanding. And where's the end game? And I think the end game has to be the simple realization that we're just seeking entertainment in this thing called life. That the desire is, kind of arbitrary. It can be anything. We can desire almost anything. And that we ought to just make ourselves desire, not to desire. There, that's pretty simple, right? Yeah, if we desire not to desire, then we have solved our problem all at once. And technically, I guess you could say that antinatalist philosophy sort of has built into it that kind of perception, a desire for the safety, the peace, the quiet, the non-torture of a world where we don't try to contrive purpose and contrive function in a mechanism that's just not made to be functional. Again, I just don't see intelligence coming to your rescue. Intelligence will, in a sense, condemn you in the end. Condemn the slow progression to the truth. Just as it's fairly easy for modern humans now to pass judgment on the humans of the past and say, how could they be? Come on, how could you be dumb enough to own a slave? How could you be dumb enough to slaughter people and steal their land? How could you not know that you were criminals? come on. How could people now not know that they're contriving a game and they're just going to, add to the pain just because they're being belligerent in accepting the truth that they're part of something that's not what it appears to be. it appears to be fluffy and friendly and la 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 la, and it just isn't. It's a horrid carnage. Takers all over. For no real function. It's all death and destruction in the end for every organism. We just put that off. what's the word for that? Procrastinate. I'll do it tomorrow. I don't want to die today. I'll do it tomorrow. And, just get through our lives. And be forced. Wait till we're forced to deal with it. And it's just not a good game. And people with intelligence should be fair-minded enough to say that this is a troublesome pile of slop we're messing with. And certainly the people who should be deciding, you know, whether we perpetuate it certainly shouldn't be the dumbest people on the planet. That they should at least be able to concede. And we shouldn't have people living drone-ish, mindless lives, sentencing consciousness to just keep reliving a mindless pursuit of absolute bullshit. Yeah. Ooh, I just cringe when I think about, you know, all the wasted pain that will have to be endured. These people just won't say stop. Stop it. Anyway. Depressed myself now. It's easy to do. It's easy to step into the truth vortex. And, eek. Feel the pain. Feel the echo of it vibrating in the ground, rumbling its ominous message. I'm coming for you. Coming for you. The horror and such. Pretty flower. Pretty flower. Pretty flower. Pretty flower. This is prettier one here. I like this one. That's a winner. Yep. Lucky. Me likey. Everything's doing quite well here. Plant-wise, just all kinds of stuff and whatnot. And blah, 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 blah. So, till the next time. Again, attempt communication in some sort of constructive manner with you folks.